A wild night full of surprises here at Wrestling DONTAKU. This is the post-game show, NJPWWorld.com. Don Callis, Kevin Kelly here in Fukuoka, at least for a few minutes longer. About four, as a matter of fact. We got three big stories tonight. Tanahashi, Okada, the main event. 12th victory for Okada. Sorry, we're doing all kinds of spoilers here. Your takeaway from the match, Okada did exactly what he wanted to do. Tanahashi had his moments. What did you think?
Okada is the better wrestler at this point in their careers, but the challenge for him mentally is he can never match the people's love of Tanahashi. In other words, you're still not over like the ace.
Yeah, but it didn't take Okada long to change his perspective and to start to look forward to Dominion and the next challenger. When no one came out, Okada spoke, and the name that he said was?
The God of Wrestling, Kenny Omega. And listen, I think this whole thing with Tanahashi, everything, the last 12 title defenses, it's in his head. People talking about Kenny Omega being a real world champion. He's now overextended himself, in my opinion. 2 out of 3 falls, no time limit. Okada, you are on the precipice. The God of Professional Wrestling, Kenny Omega, fix it to become the IWGP Heavyweight Champion.
We'll talk about Tetsuya Naito in a few moments, but I do want to touch on Will Ospreay and Kushida. A remarkable contest for the IWGP Junior Heavyweight Championship. Ospreay retains, but the night didn't end for the Aerial Assassin there.
No, great Bone Soldier
reveal
tonight.
Who sucked back in the day. He was horrible.
Doesn't suck anymore.
No.
Because Ishimori, I know from personal experience, this young man is a tremendous, tremendous athlete. And now the Bullet Club finally has what they haven't had for some time, and that's a legitimate threat to the junior heavyweight title.
Yep. Taiji Ishimori, Will Ospreay is forthcoming. Now, Tetsuya Naito, not only has Minoru Suzuki to think about, but he was also reintroduced to someone he hasn't seen since January 5th. We thought it was a fan jumping out of the crowd, but it turned out to be none other than Chris Jericho, who strikes again here, Don.
The mastermind himself, Chris Jericho. We saw a side of Naito we've never seen. We saw Naito. Naito was irreverent even towards Minoru Suzuki. Tonight, Naito was left in a bloody heap by Jericho. Jericho outmaneuvered the entire LIJ guys, came out, thought it was a fan.
Yeah, so did I.
I was saying, let's kill this fan. He's not supposed to do that. But what happened is Chris Jericho. Chris Jericho has shocked the wrestling world for the second time in the last number of months. And I think we've seen a different Naito than we've seen before. Jericho's gonna take him to school.
And again, all signs point for Dominion. And all signs point to the month of June being huge for New Japan Pro Wrestling. The month will begin with the culmination of the Best of Super Junior Tournament. We'll have coverage live for you, the tournament and the finals, right here on NJPWWorld.com. But you and I will be back together once again in Osaka Joe Hall, that beautiful historic venue, for another chapter of the Dominion series and another bout.
I may get to see Naito shut up once and for all, and Kenny Omega finally hoisting that heavyweight title. It's gonna be a great night for me personally. It's gonna be a great night for wrestling.
Be a great night for Canada. Be a great night for everyone. Well, we'll see what happens. But we'll have all the updates along the way. I guarantee you there's going to be press conferences this week regarding the Best of Super Junior field. There'll be match announcements for Dominion as well. So make sure you're dialed in, NJPWWorld.com. We're going to wrap it up here from Wrestling DONTAKU. Thanks for joining us, everybody. For Don Callis, I'm Kevin Kelly. We'll see you down the road.